Before we can create a new device type, there's a bit of pre-work outside of the software. If we're going to tell Profile Editor what a given device looks like, we have to know ourselves. For the following example, I've located the Modbus register list for my device online, but this could also come from a DNP points list, IEC 61850 substation configuration software, or ION setup, depending upon the type of device. To clarify, in my example, I'll be pretending that the PM5560 is not a Schneider Electric device, and I need to create it from scratch. In a real project, you would start on the Define Device Type Tags tab, select the device type name, and check that your device is not in this list. Now that I've determined that I need to create a new type, I'll click on Add Edit. Get familiar with the top of this window, as this format will return many times. At the top left, I'll be creating a new device type from scratch. However, if I had created a custom device type already, I could select Edit Existing and pick it from the menu. I don't see anything here because all the standard device types are locked. If I want to add a point to one of them, I'll have to select Create From to create a new device type based on the existing one, and I'll save time by copying the addresses. Finally, if I want to delete a custom device type, I'll select Delete Existing, find it in the menu, and click Delete. Back to Create New, I'll give my device type a name, which needs to be something meaningful. The category is generally the manufacturer, and subcategory is roughly what type of device this is. These options define where the device type and profiles show up in the menus. We'll see these come back later, and I'll show you where to create new categories. The driver option probably has more options than you were expecting. Some of these are obvious, like IEC 61850 and ION. The Power Modbus driver is our advanced Modbus driver, which is what I'll be using. ModNet is an older, more limited Modbus driver that I generally avoid. Most of these drivers have device-specific names. These are actually variants of the Power Modbus driver. You see, the Modbus protocol standard does not define how onboard event and data logs are stored. Instead, Schneider Electric has developed our own customized drivers to pull this data and automatically store it. We'll see this later when we discuss alarms. For now, I'll leave this at Power Modbus. At last, I can choose the tags that are used by my meter. Most of these categories are self-explanatory, but note that miscellaneous is a catch-all that includes a large number of alarms, set points, and configuration options. Be sure to check here before assuming a tag doesn't exist. Also, controls, onboard alarms, and resets are only used by those device-specific drivers that we just discussed. If you aren't working with one of those devices, ignore them. For my device type, I'll select the phase currents as well as a digital input. Of course, it's your choice of how many tags to include. You may want to include every single tag the device measures, but more often you will only add those that are useful to you in this particular project. If I find that a tag I need doesn't exist, I can add it to the profile editor using Add Edit Custom Tags, which we will discuss later. Finally, I can either save my device type and work on another, or save and exit to return from this dialog. At this point, we need to apply the addressing from the Modbus register list, which we'll go through in the next videos. Before we go, let me show you the dialog under Settings, Setup Device Type Categories, because this is where we can add new manufacturers and equipment subcategories to the profile editor menus. Once again, I can't edit anything here, because the defaults are locked. Next, let's set up that device addressing. Until then, thank you.